welcome to the video. I'm John, and this is part 6 of the stop sign guitar build. If you've ever done any paintwork before, you know the secret to every good paint job lies in the prep work. And in this case, I really had my work cut out for me. In the beginning, this was a very rough fiberglass surface, and in the video, I'm going to show how I transformed it into a nice, smooth, consistent painted surface. I really put a lot of time and work into this, and it really paid off, and I couldn't be happier with it. As far as the neck goes, there wasn't as much work involved, but I was a little concerned about how the paint would react with the wood compared to the fiberglass, but it's pretty consistent. I'm pretty happy with how it looks. The only thing that drove me a little nuts was the headstock decal. The whole design of the headstock was really based around that logo being there, and I really wanted it there, but it took me over a month to figure out how to get it on there and make it look good. I ran into all kinds of problems, and in the video I'm not going to go into every little detail, but in the end I think it turned out pretty nice. After the body popped out of the mold, it got a quick sand to get rid of any sharp edges. At that point, getting it ready for paint was far down the road. A lot of parts had to be fitted to the body, and things like the neck hole location had to be figured out. The fiberglass surface is not only rough, but full of air bubbles and imperfections. The body is covered with Bondo, then sanded down with 80 grit sanding blocks. But it's not until the body gets its first coat of primer that all the imperfections and flaws are revealed. Now I go into what I call the spot putty primer sand repeat stage. This is done until there are no more imperfections. When the body is baby butt smooth, then I know it's ready for paint. Just like everything else on this guitar, I spent a lot of time not only choosing the color, but the type of paint to use. I went with a textured gunmetal metallic gray automotive acrylic enamel finish. What I liked about this paint was the heavy metallic flake. It reminded me of a vintage Gretsch, and that goes along with the vintage theme of this guitar. The paint has a very thick consistency and sprayed on like truck bedliner. Getting runs or sags are almost impossible. Before the paint completely dries, I peel the tape off the binding to reveal what the guitar will look like when it's completed. Even though I'm excited to see the body finally painted, I still have to apply the clear coat. The idea is to apply several coats of clear, sanding between each coat, over the textured paint to produce a smooth semi-gloss finish. Before I clear coat the body, I spray a layer of clear on the binding only, to hopefully even out the thickness of the surface. I want a level, even transition from paint to binding. I sprayed the entire body with 2 coats of clear to build up the thickness, then wet sanded with 220 grit. I try not to be too aggressive and burn through to the gray. Most of the texture and the binding transition are almost gone. Next, I spray a light coat of clear and this time wet sand with 400 grit. The surface is about 98% where I want it. One more coat of clear and it's as good as it's going to get. I'm really happy with the look of the satin finish. The transition from binding to paint looks as if it's one molded piece. Now it's time to move on to the neck. This was a neck that I bought from a discount guitar parts website. The neck was complete and had been installed on a guitar at one point, but had never been used. Besides the scratches and dings, I did find a couple of flaws, but nothing that couldn't be fixed. And for the price I paid, it was well worth the investment. Since the neck had been finished, I didn't need to worry about a sealer coat, except on places that I modified, a small contour at the heel, and pretty much the entire headstock. I call the paint scheme a reverse Les Paul, paint on the neck and back of the headstock, and wood grain on the top of the headstock. The process for painting the neck was pretty much the same as the body, except before the final clear coat, I had to get the front of the headstock worked out. One of the things I'm proud about most on this guitar is that it's the first one with my logo on the headstock. It's also the first decal I've tried to make. I spent a lot of time researching it, and it looked pretty straightforward and easy to do. But where I ran into problems was right from the first test that I did, and the second, and the third. It didn't matter what I did, nothing seemed to work for me. I was convinced that I had bought bad decal paper and that I might have to scrap the idea, at least for this guitar. I decided to go back and follow the instructions that came with the decals to the letter, even buying the same brand clear coat. I was amazed with the results that I was getting with the next couple of tests that I made. So I decided to go ahead and try it out on the headstock. Since I'm using a regular inkjet printer, I can't print gold, silver, or white. I wanted the logo to have gold letters and a black border. Before I applied the decal, I used a stencil and a gold Sharpie to color in where the letters will go. It may not be perfect when you look close at it, but a few inches away, it looks amazing. So far, everything is working out, and now I'm ready to clear coat over the decal. This is when I ran into another problem, and for a while, I thought I would have to sand down the headstock and start from scratch. My problem just didn't seem to make any sense. The edge of the decal would curl up and leave a low spot in the finish, no matter how many coats of clear I applied. The only thing that I could think of to fix this was to dab on clear coat in the low spots and block sand it after it dried, then spray one light coat on the entire neck and headstock with the semi-gloss clear. At this point, I felt I had nothing to lose. It was an unconventional way to fix the problem, but it worked. Looking at the headstock, you could never tell that I had that much trouble.
You know, I think it's really funny that with all the problems and challenges that I had to overcome on this guitar project, that a simple little thing like a headstock decal gave me the biggest headache. Something I've been wanting to say for months, next video, final assembly. I'm going to go over many of the parts that I haven't talked about, why I chose them, how I had to modify them to fit the guitar, but most important thing is I'm going to be able to play it so we can hear what it sounds like. As always, check out my other videos, share them, check me out on Facebook. Thanks for watching.